In this video, I would like to explain you what pass the hash attack is and how it works. Okay, what is the pass the hash attack? Let's imagine that we have corporate domain network and computers running Windows operating systems. And we have a pen tester who compromised one of the computers in the network domain. From this computer, pen tester grabs a password hash of domain administrator. Having this hash, he is able to compromise any computer in corporate network. And he doesn't have to crack a password hash. It is possible to connect to any computer using just a password hash. You may ask, how is it possible? Well, let's review how Windows computers authenticate each other in the network. I prepared a simplified drawing to better understand the principle of operation. Let's consider NTLM network authentication between host and domain controller. A TCP connection is already established between them. The host initiates a connection request to the main controller using SMB protocol. It looks like this. Hi, I'm Peter and I would like to connect to you. The main controller sends a special random sequence to be encrypted by the host. It looks like this. No problem, but first, I want you to encrypt this sequence for me. Now the host performs the following procedure. It encrypts received random sequence using the password hash which is stored in its SAM database. And after that we have a new hash. This hash is sent to the domain controller. The domain controller performs the same action. It calculates a new hash using its random sequence which was sent to the host and the password hash of user account. Then both hashes are compared. And if they match, the domain controller grants access, otherwise it denies. Now you can see that both computers, the host and domain controller, do not have a plain text password. Instead, they keep only password hash, and this hash is used for network authentication. So if a pen tester gets the password hash of domain administrator who has access to many computers in the network, he will be able to connect to any computer in the main network. And this type of attack is still actual in present time. Now let's take a look at tools which can implement this type of attack. And in the next video we are going to make this in practice using PSExec tool in Metasploit. Now let's see how to implement this attack in real world. We are going to use PSExec module in Metasploit framework. Let's imagine that you have password hash of domain administrator. With this hash you can access any computer in domain. Because in our lab there are no domain and domain administrator, we need to modify our registry settings to log in with the password hash of local administrator. And we need the following registry hives. Local account token filter policy disables user access control for local administrators. What does it mean? In local computer there can be two types of administrators, local and domain admins. If you try to log in the system remotely as the local admin, the connection will be refused by default due to security reasons. That is why we need to disable this feature. If you try to log in the system as a domain admin, the connection will be granted by default. To edit registry settings, hold Windows key and press R key. Then type regedit command. Now we need to find the following hive. If there is no required key in the hive, we can edit manually. You don't have to reboot computer. The second key is used for higher security. It digitally signs all the messages when performing network authentication. By default, it is disabled. So the lab machine is prepared. Now let's use PSExec module integrated to Metasploit. This program was designed by Mark Rusanovich for remote administration of Windows systems. Execute the following command. Set payload. Now let's see what options must be set. It's well known R-host and L-host. Then we need to set values for SMB user and SMB pass. In one of the previous videos we already dumped password hash and username, so let's try to use them. I'm going to use this user because he belongs to a group of local administrators. So, all the options are set and we can launch the module. From the output you can see that attack was successful. And we have system privileges.